Hello YouTube, welcome back to my video. So in this video we are going to discuss about REST FB Facebook API. So it's actually a Facebook Graph API client written in Java for Java developers. Through this video we'll be checking how we can get an active Facebook access token for a user to call REST FB API calls or Facebook Graph API calls. Okay, now let's open the REST FB documentation and check out some basic stuff which we can do using REST FB AP. Okay, so first one, what we can see here is getting the username. This is the code for there, so we'll try this one. So this code is actually to get the information or the name of the current logged in user and to get the number of likes to for a page code. So this is a page name, Coca-Cola. We can pass any name here. So let's try running this code using our Eclipse IDE with a simple Java program. Okay. Okay, this is my Eclipse IDE. If you don't have your Eclipse IDE, go to my video section. Have another video how you can get Eclipse IDE for Java developers. Now I'm going to create a simple dynamic web project here. So I'm creating dynamic web project because we will further move on to the dynamic version or the client version of this project. So I'm giving it as the REST FB. I'm giving it REST FB me. Okay, so we'll be basically fetching the user information and the page like as we saw in that documentation. Now just click finish and wait for your dynamic web project to be loaded. Yes, the project has been created. As you can see here, the web kernel is there and the Java resource folder is there. Inside this we are going to create our package. So I'm giving the package name as REST FB. Okay, so inside this one I'm just creating a class named we can give any name, so I'm giving it as get user details. Okay, I'm just giving this one, just give user details. Okay, and we need a main method inside this. Just click the check mark this one and just click finish and wait for your Java class to be created. Yes, the class have been created with the main method inside. Now let's go to the REST FB documentation and I'm going to copy paste all these till this here and copy this, come back to our code and paste it here. Okay, so definitely there will be an error because we should take these all are REST FB API, so we should add the dependencies a jar file in our project class path. Okay, so let's go to the documentation and let's see where the jar file is here. So the jar file we can get from the home page itself. We can see here in just go down where you can see the download from Maven. Okay, so we can directly go to the Maven central and where we can directly download the jar available. So we'll get updated the latest version is of 2.0.0. just open it and you can have the dependency here and you can download the jar from here. Okay, now just click on the jar and let your browser download it. So it's already downloaded. I'm gonna keep it. Now we have to add this one in our class path, so let me copy this from here. I have just copied the jar file into desktop REST FB to this folder. So this is the jar. Now let's copy this one to the library folder or to the class path. You can go either way. So I'm going to copy this one to my library path here. So this is the library path. Just paste it here. And let's start importing these files. I mean these classes from there. Just press Control Space. So if I'm just pressing Control Space, he can just import it from there, and the page is also from REST FB type. I'm giving this as system.out.println instead of out.println, and this one also same system.out.println. Okay, the parameter is also from REST FB. And now we can see here the Facebook client object. It is not a local variable, so we have to instantiate this one. So I'll show you how you can use this. So I have just created a Facebook client object here. So this is also from RESTFB, and the default Facebook client also is from RESTFB, and again the version is also from RESTFB. Okay, now we have to give a user token here. Okay, so this is where we give user token. Now let's try running this one without giving a user token and see the output. Just go to run as and select run as Java application. Yes, as you can see here, the Java program has been run, and the error message active access token must be used to create information has come here. Okay, so we should supply an active access token here. So right now we are going to get the access token manually from the Facebook Graph API, and but we'll in the next video we'll check how we can get that dynamically. Okay, so now let's go to the browser and get the access token from the Facebook API directly using manually. Okay, so just search in Google Graph API Graph API Explorer. Okay, so once you search it, you will get a link. So this one is the link, Graph API Explorer Facebook for Developers. Just open it. So once you open it, this is the Explorer tool where we can get the access token dynamically. Okay, so to get the access token which we have to use the so just click on the get token, and we are going to get a user access token. Okay, just click on this one, and as you can see here, by default it has all these permissions. So all we need is a user about me, and all others let it be there. I'm not going to uncheck anything. Just click on get access token. So once you click it, yeah, there will be a pop-up to get allow your privileges, allow all the privileges for this Graph API tool. Okay, so by default we are getting there is a web service here which, if we are passing like this one with this access token, it will return the username and the name and ID of user which currently logged in. So I have already logged in my Facebook app. So I have already logged in my Facebook, that's why the name is coming my name. Okay, Jinu Java. So let's copy this access token from here and go back to our code, and let's paste this here. Okay, so I'm just blindly paste this all string value here. Just save it, and let's try running this one again. So if I'm just going to run as Java application and wait for some time to get executed, here it is. Okay, so my username has been come. So this access token we have just manually copied from the tool and pasted it here, and the page like which is coming here is for this particular page. Let's try some another page from Facebook. Let me open my Facebook. So I have just opened two Facebook pages. So this page is some amazing facts, and this page is Qatar Day. Okay, so let me copy the name of this page, copy this one, and come back to our code, and I am pasting that name here. Okay, the name of the page. And now if I am just given an S Java application, it should return me the number of likes which this page is actually having. So this page is actually having this much likes. So let's come back to the page, and it's 335 5531. Okay, you can see here 335 and 5530. So by this time it got one more like, so that's why it's one more extra. Okay, so about this page, you can see here the page has 594249 likes. So copy this here again and paste it here, and if I'm just running it is from here, you can see here it should return the same, or yeah, see the same 594249 page like. Okay, so this is how you can get the dynamic user, the REST FB API, to get the name, and how you can solve the error to get a new Facebook user access token to access anything from Facebook. Okay, so which now we have just manually copied the access token from the API tool. In my next video, I'll show you how you can get dynamically from the user and get all the information of the user. through REST API. Okay, so hope you got this. If you have any doubt in this, please comment below. I'll be helping you, and I'll share all the source code in my description. You can have it, and please like and subscribe for my videos, and thanks for watching.